Hello everyone, welcome to the lecture. Today we'll be talking about this adrenergic system and sympathalamic tracts. So let's have a look at the contents that we'll be discussing today. We'll be looking at the synthesis of adrenaline or noradrenaline. Then we'll look at the metabolism of adrenaline and noradrenaline, the autoinhibitory feedback mechanisms, the adrenergic receptors. Then we'll be talking about sympathomimetics, both catecholamines and non-catecholamines. Right? In catecholamines, we'll be talking about ephedrine and norepinephrine. And then we'll go on to talk about acetaminophen, pyrimine, and ephedrine-like drugs. Okay, so coming to adrenaline synthesis. The first step in the synthesis, in the adrenaline synthesis, is the conversion of L-tyrosine into DOPA. DOPA stands for dihydroxyphenylalanine. What we can see is that the tyrosine is getting converted into dopamine, and here the enzyme tyrosine hydroxylase plays a major role. However, the conversion of tyrosine into DOPA, it is the most slowest step that is encountered in the adrenaline synthesis, and therefore this step is called the rate limiting step. Here you can see that tyrosine molecule is converted into DOPA. Here in this conversion, this hydroxy group is added because we are the enzyme tyrosine hydroxylase adds a hydroxy group out here. Then the second step is the conversion of DOPA into dopamine. In the conversion of DOPA to dopamine, we see that the enzyme DOPA decarboxylase has been used, right? So here, because there is a decarboxylase enzyme, what it does is it basically removes the COOH group that was present out here in DOPA and replaces it with H, right? So in case of dopamine, there is no COOH group because of the decarboxylase enzyme. Now, after the dopamine has been formed, the dopamine is converted into noradrenaline, right? And this conversion takes place in the presence of dopamine beta hydroxylase. So what you see is that this is again a hydroxylase enzyme, quite like tyrosine hydroxylase. So this hydroxylase enzyme is going to add another OS group again. So here you see that a OS group has been added out here, right, in case of noradrenaline. Once noradrenaline is formed, this noradrenaline is again changed into adrenaline. But then the change of noradrenaline to adrenaline or the synthesis of adrenaline takes place only in adrenal medulla. The conversion of noradrenaline to adrenaline takes place in the presence of phenylethanolamine and methyl transferase. That is, a methyl group needs to be transferred to this NH. Right? So here you can see that a methyl group has been transferred. Okay. So this is about the synthesis of adrenaline. Now let us have a look at the metabolism. The metabolic degradation of catecholamines, it basically, there are two main enzymes that are involved in the metabolic degradation of catecholamines. The first is monoamine oxidase, and the second is catechol-O-methyl transferase. So monoamine oxidase, we call it MAO, catechol-O-methyl transferase, we name it COMT as well. Both the endogenous and exogenous catecholamines, they are metabolized by these two enzymes. Okay, have a look at the various neurotransmitters that are given and the action of MAO and COMT in them. What you can see is that ephedrine under the action of COMT gets converted into metanephrine, right? Similarly, norepinephrine under the action of COMT gets converted into normetanephrine. Dopamine, similarly, under the action of COMT gets converted into 3-methoxypyrimine. And when MAO acts on epinephrine, right, it forms dihydroxymandelic acid. Similarly, norepinephrine also under the action of MAO gives dihydroxymandelic acid. Here, COOH group has replaced this part in both epinephrine and norepinephrine. Under the action of MAO, dopamine changes into dihydroxyphenylacetic acid. This dihydroxymandelic acid under the action of COMT then converts into 3-methoxy-4-hydroxymandelic acid or vinylmandelic acid. This is called VMAAC. And this dihydroxyphenyl acetic acid under the action of COMT forms homovanillic acid. Similarly, 3-methoxytyramine under the action of MAO forms homovanillic acid. So when it comes to this to the excretion of metabolites, right, VMA, homovanillic acid, they all are found excreted in urine, and VMA, this is found in much higher amounts in case of pheochromocytoma. Let us have a look. Monoamine oxidase. Monoamine oxidase occurs within the cells. It is basically abundant in noradrenergic nerve terminals, but it is also present in different places like liver and intestinal epithelium. It can oxidize other monoamine oxidase like other monoamines, the important ones being dopamine and 5-hydroxytryptamine. MAO is more important in the CNS as compared to the periphery. The other enzyme we discussed earlier is COMT, right? COMT is present in acromedulla and many other cells and tissues. The final metabolite that is formed by the action of MAO and COMT is 3-hydroxy-4-methoxymandelic acid or vanillyl mandelic acid. The intermediate metabolites that are partly conjugated or that are formed are partly conjugated to sulfate or glucuronide derivatives, and then they are finally excreted in urine. But most of it is converted into vanillyl mandelic acid, and that is then excreted in urine. As I discussed earlier, in patients of pheochromocytoma, which secrete the amines, it's a rare cause of high blood pressure. In this case, we see that the urinary excretion of VMA is markedly increased, and this is the diagnostic test for the condition. In the periphery, neither MAO nor COMT is primarily responsible for the termination of transmitter action, and most of the released neurotransmitter is quickly recaptured by optic 1. Circulating catecholamines are usually inactivated by a combination of optic 1, optic 2, or COMT. For noradrenaline, it's basically optic 1. Adrenaline, it's basically the optic 2. And for isoproterenol, it's optic 2 and COMT. Optic 1 is when the optic happens to the same neuron from which the neurotransmitter is released, and optic 2 happens in the postjunctional membrane. Thank you. That is all for today.